Nigga!
Welcome to this Thursday night in the NBA, right here on 2K Sports. Alongside Richard Jefferson, Greg Anthony, and our reporter David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. And we welcome, we got another seat right here in the NBA, no better insider than Shams Charania. Hey, Shams, great to have you with us.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. It's great to be here. I'm honored. I'm privileged.
Look at Richard Jefferson. He's like a kid in a candy store. He cannot wait to talk to you.
Yes, we love RJ.
And now a chance to look here at the race for Rookie of the Year. Halfway through the season, these are the top rookies so far. Well, you look at Bouzelis. As soon as the season started, he started impacting games with his play. That's rare to see from a rookie, and that's why he's number four for us.
And he has had a dynamic start to his first season of NBA basketball. He might not be at the top of that list, but he has been great all the same.
Even though it's early in the season, there's no question he belongs here at this level. He's got a clear NBA skill set.
Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. Levine and Williams up in the forward positions. The franchise is out there with Josh Giddey. And it's Vucevic in at the center, locking down the middle. And for Boston, Holiday in the backcourt. To his side is White. Tatum in the front court alongside Horford. And it's Cornette in at the five, roaming the paint. Shams, no team is going to run off titles like Boston did in the 60s. But these Celtics have a chance to win their share. What a great start for them.
An absolutely loaded roster. Everyone can defend. Everyone can shoot. They love the versatility they have on their team. And you have to be able to play multiple positions and be versatile to play on this team. It's hard to find a weak link. And it's really championship or bust in Boston.
And it feels so great for their coach, Joe Mazzulla. I know we'll get into that down the road. What a great job he's done.
A young coach who has really found his stride.
Now here's White. After the miss from Terrell, Tatum kicks to Holland. Good, and it's Tatum picking up the assist.
Drew making the game look easy with that three.
Here's Chicago. Six-point game. Williams passes to Terrell. Back to Williams. Pass to Terrell. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Just five to shoot. Here's Giddey, trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. A
Holiday looking over the floor. Down low. Cornett can't get it to go. Now for Boston, their last game, a loss to the Hornets in Charlotte.
Total embarrassment. I was shocked at how poorly they played. I think they were shocked.
Well, we'll see how they respond after that weak performance. It should tell us a lot about their character as a team.
Here's White after the Bulls pick up two. And Horford wide open. He shoots. No good on the triple.
Shocking that he just bricked that one. The defense got real lucky there.
Giddy the pass to Terrell. That shot misses. Good D by Holiday.
They're one of four here to start, looking to get into a flow offensively.
Tatum wide open. He fires one. Again, the miss by the Celtics. For Chicago, they've gone just one of four to get this game started. Terrell off target with his three.
Just haven't found their offensive footing yet, only managing to sink one of their first five shots.
And with the new broadcasting deals, NBA salaries figuring Shams to skyrocket.
And we're not even just talking about the players, Kevin. It's the coaches. It's the front office executives. Everyone is seeing some massive, massive paydays. Every single year, we're seeing the biggest contract in league history, and it's only going to get bigger and bigger in years to come.
Are you surprised at the size of some of these coaching deals? I mean, the numbers are amazing.
Coaching, these front office deals, it's getting higher and higher. And once Monty Williams signed the deal he did in 2023, that only elevated the market for coaches, and front office executives also are getting big payments.
Doing exactly what you expect. Vooch setting a solid screen that gets things going.
Boston leading by four. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer, David Alton. David.
Hey, Kevin. Briefly spoke with Joe Mazzulla. I asked him what plan he had, if any, for Zach LaVine. He said, my focus is making sure he doesn't get any easy shots. We have to contest every attempt. It's about mitigating the damage, not preventing it. So it looks like he'll settle for just making LaVine work as hard as possible. Guys?
Thank you, David. Now, here's Tatum. After the miss from Terrell, Tatum passes to Horford. Over Williams. The kick out to Tatum. Vucevic with the rebound. Bulls trail by six. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And Boston has possession. Outside, Horford. Pass to Tatum. Offensive rebound. Holiday gets the bucket. Holiday's got his third bucket of the night.
In so many different ways, Adi's work ethic, it shows up.
On the wing, Giddy. And it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That's his first foul.
Personal foul. First team foul.
Hey, Shams, we know you've reported on so many big trades that did happen. Were there ever a few that were close to happening but may have fallen apart at the 11th hour?
I always wait until things are 100% confirmed, but listen, there's always a trade or two that's viewed as done but just does not happen, whether it sours, whether something falls apart. There's always one deal or two that falls apart at the trade deadline or in the offseason, but I try to wait as best I can and make sure that when I report, it is confirmed.
Fantastic passing big. Horford makes great decisions with the ball.
Terrell, the pass to Vucevic. LaVine kicks to Giddy. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Bulls shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line. That free throw good from Terrell. Both free throws good from Terrell.
For a star like him, you get lots of opportunities at the line, and he's great at cashing them in.
And so it's Holiday with it. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics, leading by 5. To the paint. And it's slammed in by Holiday.
The athletic ability of Holiday on full display there.
Williams passes to Terrell. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That one is on Holiday. All right, we'll take a look now at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
So far, they haven't had to force anything. They're swinging the ball around and turning good passing into points.
And something else that I liked is how they attack the paint, finding ways to get inside and capitalize time and time again.
Now, here's Tatum.
Oh, wow! That is powerful. One of the craziest dunks we've seen. Tatum with the bounce.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
In their last contest, guys, he was unconscious from the foul line.
Williams gets a screen from Terrell. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. 6 to shoot. Pass to Williams. Here's Giddy. No good from outside. And you look at the NBA, Shams, any changes you'd like to see?
To me, it's having players stay healthy, right? I would love to have a rule that players just play and the top players are there playing the most meaningful moments of regular season games and allowing players to have freedom defensively. And the league can find plenty of other ways to discourage players, but to allow players to really be there in the big moments to defend at a high level. And I would just love to have a healthy serum that we can spread around the league and keep these guys in.
I think here at the table, we're all nodding our heads, looking up and down. We all agree completely with what you're saying. Bulls trail by 10. Here's Terrell. He had a 30-point outing their last game against Toronto.
And defensively, he's been all over the place, wreaking havoc and pouncing on a number of steals.
To the inside. Here's Pritchard. A shot, no good. Great D that time for Vucevic. Shoots it. Terrell misses.
And usually that's a bucket for him, but look, nobody's perfect in the mid-range.
Tatum.
Oh, nice finish.
Excellent all-around performance so far. Hence the big lead.
They got off to such a hot start, and that can keep you energized throughout the whole game.
And Billy Donovan decides to call timeout. He's ready to talk things through with the team. And the Bulls with some changes. Jalen. Game for Chicago, it was a loss to the Raptors in Toronto.
Well, they made a few key shots but missed many more. It was a rough night for them offensively.
And tonight, I expect them to play better offensively, try to get some closer looks.
Tatum in the front court alongside Horford. Then it's Lonnie Walker. And it's Pritchard in a point. That's the 5 to begin the second quarter for the Celtics. Here's Pritchard. That's a 2-pointer from Walker. Rebounded by Vucevic. Vucevic has got his 6th rebound on the night. We have all these great foreign players. Maybe 3 of the top 5 players in the NBA are all foreign players, right? And so much was made of Anthony Edwards. Here's a 22-year-old American player who has maybe the charisma, the game, the everything you could package. It could be our next great player. Is there ever talk around the league about why are European players being so dominant? Where are the great young American players to compete against this great influx of international players?
the grassroots programs, you have to look at what happens abroad and in the States. You have to give a lot of credit to the way that they develop players over in Europe, in any of those regions. They do a great job, and those players are hungry, they're driven, they're passionate. They're trying to get here to the States and play basketball at the highest level in the NBA. And you see at the amateur level, there can be a lot of fluidity, there can be a lot of flux. And players are given so much so soon in America. So to be able to have that chip on your shoulder, to have the passion, and to exude the confidence that Anthony Edwards has, the younger generation of players definitely have someone that Anthony Edwards to look up to.
Here's Pritchard, 8 points for him, just 4 to shoot. Latrey kept alive. Here's Tillman, pass to Pritchard, and the three off target.
Slow going for him this quarter. The defense putting up a good fight.
Here's Terrell. To Terry. Three-pointer. The shot, no good. Great D that time from Tatum. Here's Pritchard. He's covered by Terrell. Pritchard passes to Horford. The three from Tatum. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Horford's got 3 assists in the game. And Billy Donovan decides to call timeout. And coach has decided they need a moment to talk things over.
Bulls trail by 11.
Here's Terrell. 7 points in the game. Shot to stop the run. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls. Terrell's got 9. And in last year's playoff, Shams, we did see a lot of players injured and unable to play. What are some of the solutions that may be being talked about that you hear about?
People certainly ask if this is the result of the 65-game rule. Is it the more physical play? Is it the consequences of the regular season? The league is going to take a wait-and-see approach to determine if this is an issue they have to fix. But they do love the results of what this has brought as far as player availability moving forward.
Yeah, they do seem sold on that 65 number, don't they?
100%. And at the end of the day, some of these injuries are flukish. There's a lot of, obviously, lower body injuries, and you can't measure that. I think the league is going to want to see more data over the next 5 to 10 years to really determine, does this rule impact the game and impact you?
And with an update from the sideline, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, the franchise in the last game against the Raptors was tremendous. He finished with 30 points, and his passing was phenomenal with a ton of assists. And this just speaks to the star that he is. He's able to put the team on his back and deliver. Guys?
Yeah, David, in stretches, he was absolutely dominant. Greg, he'd love to match that performance tonight.
This team needs his contributions. When he's right, he makes winning plays time and time again.
Expect them to go to him early and often. Don't want to let that hot hand go to waste.
Austin leading by 12. Outside Tatum. Oh, and the jam by Tatum.
What muscle on that finish. It's hard trying to prevent Tatum from converting.
Pick by Vucevic. Here's Terrell. He takes it in. Off target at the rim.
Outstanding work to send him away. They sniffed that one out.
Inside. Tillman's shot is off. Bulls trail by 14. Terry the pass to Terrell. Trying to find Vucevic. Gets it to him. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
Bulls shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And you look at the way the league is moving now, Shams, are there less big trades than when you started or more?
Perhaps a little bit less, but listen, the league is trying to keep parity in this league and allow teams to be able to keep their homegrown stars. There's always going to be plenty of interest, and that level of interest, not only from players, from competing teams, but fans' interest it's never been higher.
And there's never any hesitancy, right? If a team feels they can get better, for whatever reason and however they do it, I don't think there's any hesitancy to pulling the trigger.
Particularly when you're on the cusp of potentially winning a championship or competing, whether it's competing for the playoffs, competing for a title, if you can make one move that takes you from point A to point B, teams and general managers want to do it.
Well said. And here's Boston. They're on a 15-6 run. Tatum, no good.
That's just a bucket like you expect him to make. It's tough when you miss them.
And a fast break now for the Celtics. Walker's shot is off. To the middle. Here's Terry. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1-for-4.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Pass to Pritchard. Hands it from downtown. Pritchard's got 13 points.
You can't lose a shooter like him on the court. The ball will find its way to him, and he will drill a three each time.
Here's Terrell. That misses off the backboard.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Shireman can hit. And so White will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. Trailing by 13.
Hot off the drive, White is so explosive, leaping off the floor and throwing that one down.
Boston's gone for the three-pointer 7 times here in the second and been successful 3 times.
He's looked practically unstoppable this quarter. The defense, yeah, well, they haven't had many answers for him.
And it's the Bulls with the ball after the basket by Boston. Terrell misses.
Let's just say his subpar shooting is just one reason why they are trailing in this ball game.
Tatum, no good.
Now, I understand that that shot didn't go down, but they will take that look every trip down the floor.
Deshaun for the Bulls. The overall approach has seemed to be steady as she goes, stay in our lane, business as usual. But do you think that will continue?
And business has been good, Kevin. One of the best attendance rates in the league. But listen, this is a Bulls organization that has to figure out its right direction and see how they can continue to build and find a way to build from the ground up and reach new heights, whether it is going a more rebuilding route, more in the middle route, versus going and really taking big swings. I think this is an organization that is very much trying to find their direction.
Oh, you're kind of setting the table. What could happen with this team? Good stuff. Derek White checked in for the Celtics. Holiday comes in for Lonnie Walker. Chicago also making some changes. Levine's checked in for Terry. And Josh Giddey's subbed in for White. Boston leading by 10. It's stolen. Here's Terrell. Williams with the ball. Now guarded by Tatum. Here's Terrell. He's got 16. Williams with a clean look. The shot's good on the assist by Vucevic.
3 points.
Williams has got it back down to single digits for the Bulls. The Celtics shooting at 48% from the floor. Looking good. Here's Pritchard. 15 points in the game. The three from Tatum. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Tatum's got 13 points in just this quarter.
And he's now made 3 three-pointers here in the second. Starting to get it going.
Here's Terrell. Lock at 6. And Boston with the rebound. Pritchard's got rebound number 5 here tonight.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Tatum's shot is off. Bulls trail by 10. Giddey with it. He's picked up by White. From deep, 3-point land. Oh, drew the foul and almost hit the 3-point bucket, but he'll go to the line to shoot 3.
Yeah, good job trying to get a hand in the face, but you've got to be more careful.
The Bulls have been excellent at the free throw line here today, a flawless 6-for-6. The Celtics making a switch here. Horford's checked in. The Bulls also changing it up. Jalen Smith comes in for Nikola Vucevic. And it's Torrey Craig in for Williams. Celtics leading by 7. Here's White. And it's off from 3-point range. White against Giddey. Terrell, the pass to Giddey. They set the pick to the right side. And it's good. 3 points on the board on the shot from Terrell. Terrell's got a pair of triples in the second now for Chicago. Boston's gotten fond of that three-point shot here in the second quarter. 4 of 9. Outside, Horford. In the corner, Tatum with it. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Horford's got his fourth assist in this one.
The efficiency from Tatum on the offensive end is terrific, not letting any scoring chances pass him by.
Here's Terrell. 22 points for him. And LaVine throws it down.
Such a fluid play. LaVine is in the air right on cue to put a smooth finish on that alley-oop.
And here's White. Pass to Holiday. Horford against Gray. Now here's White. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Hornets in Charlotte.
He's more than chipped in on the glass as well. Just a tremendous effort last time out.
And Shams, what an absolute delight it has been having you courtside with all of us tonight. Thank you so much for taking time to join us. It has been a true pleasure.
Thanks so much for the invite. I can't wait to do it again sometime. I'm honored. I'm privileged.
Oh, we are going to hold you to that. Thank you again. And just great to have Shams join us, isn't it, guys? Such a wealth of knowledge.
Yeah, no one is more locked in on the league. If there's a move happening, Shams knows about it before the players do.
Here's Horford after the made shot from Terrell. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And, yep, that's going to be a flagrant foul. Unnecessary contact.
Boy, a very hard foul that time. And the officials had to slap him with the flagrant. I mean, you can't let him get away with that kind of contact.
Yeah, gee, that's an easy call for the officials to make when there's that much contact. The league is really cracking down on those sort of plays. Richard, so many things about Drew Holiday's game we love, but what impresses you most about his game?
Well, I know it's an easy answer, but it's his defense. It's hard to be a feared defender in the modern NBA, Kevin. But Holiday is sick.
Performance for Jason Tatum. He has been the story so far for the Boston Celtics. He's at the quarter century mark. 25 points for him in this game as they have looked to him over and over to make things happen. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here.
Howdy, folks. The moment you've been waiting for is here. Before we recap the first half, let's see what the standings look like in the East.
Checking out the Celtics. You know, Halloween was a long time ago, but this team is still the scariest group in the league. They're striking fear into every team that has to go against them, Shaq.
You're starting to scare me, Kenny.
Oh, okay. That wasn't scary.
Now moving on to the Boston Celtics and the close first half they played.
I love the depth of this team, man. Their subs have been huge tonight, giving them a scoring punch that they needed most.
And credit their coach for a rather liberal substitution pattern. He mixed and matched beautifully in that first half. And that is a wrap. Now let's send you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And then as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. You know, guys, Jason Tatum has really been making it happen.
Yeah, pretty much all throughout that first half. And he was taking care of his business on the low blocks and getting more than his fair share of dunks.
He has been aggressive, getting into the painted areas seemingly at will and wreaking absolute havoc on the defense.
Bulls trail by four. So for Chicago right now, Vucevic in at center with Williams next to him. Josh Giddey is out there with the franchise, and it's LaVine in at the three. Fires it up. Holiday with the block.
You can't say enough about Holiday's defensive instincts. It's exceptional.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that one.
He is never going to take his foot off a pedal.
And that finish shows you how dangerous he can be as a passer and a finisher.
And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. The kick out to Holiday. Buries the long-range jumper. Holiday's got 18 points in the game.
And then they continue to control the glass.
And now we've got some time to check in from the sideline. You got for us, D.A.?
Kevin, the Celtics can beat you in a number of ways.
Point guard Jrue Holiday said, we can play small and big. We have great bench players who come in and change the game at any time and could start on other teams. And we have a hunger. Kevin, they're going to be a problem for a long time.
Agreed. Yeah, they are stacked, D.A., for sure. White looking around. Back to Tatum. And a miss there on the triple. Bulls trail by seven. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. LaVine gets a screen from Terrell. Launches a three. Rebound, Boston. Horford's got four rebounds in this game. Right side, White. Now here's Tatum. Goodbye, Terrell. And Tatum the bucket on the assist by White. Tatum's got 28 points for the game.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball move.
Terrell, the pass to Vucevic. Here's Terrell, guarded by Holiday. Six on the shot clock. LaVine, jump shot is good. He's got eight.
This is how LaVine operates. He hunts down shots and then fully commits to his selection.
Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Celtics leading by eight. And Giddey over to help. And here's Tatum for three. Chicago grabs the miss. Giddey with it. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. From the wing. And they get it back. Here's Terrell. No good on the three.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
RJ, one league rule that has gotten a lot of attention. Carrying the basketball.
Oh, these guys carry the ball at a ridiculous rate. Even Allen Iverson used to do it, and then eventually he took it out of his game. But yeah, the referees could clean it up a little bit, I'll be honest.
Some people could say he's struggling on offense this period. I like to think of more of drowning. Just can't seem to find his confidence.
And you watch Jason Tatum, year to year, he is a model of consistency. Across the board, the numbers are pretty similar, and the effort never wanes.
Now look, from the moment he stepped into this league, Jason Tatum has been a difference maker. Every team in the league is looking for guys like him. Long, athletic, and most importantly, winners.
And the timeout called here by Billy Donovan. He wants a minute here to get things straightened out with his team. third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Here's Terrell, right covering Williams for three, nailed from three-point land. Williams has got 8 points.
He's getting after it, but needs some help if they're going to get it done.
And here's White. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Pass to Horford. To the paint. And it's slammed in by Holiday.
Keep it simple if I were them. Feed Holiday. Let Drew eat. He's been having a fantastic night.
Here's Terrell, guarded by Holiday. And Levine throws it down.
And maybe that'll trigger them. Impossible not to get pumped up after that.
Yeah, well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are pumped up. Now Holiday, he's got 20.
And now they've chosen the full court man-to-man.
Here's White, back to Holiday. Goes up with the stripe, and he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Holiday's got 9 points here in the second half. Here's Terrell, 24 points for him. Right wing. Tatum against Levine. Levine gets a screen from Terrell. It's good. Levine's got 8 points in the quarter.
He's just got it on automatic right now, shooting 100%, and that'll keep your confidence high.
Boston leading by 9. Outside, White. Back to Holiday. Down low, Tatum. Slammed home, and he draws the foul. A chance for another point at the free throw line. That one on Vucevic.
Okay, just some big boy strength there from Tatum. Just put himself to the line.
And the Bulls making a change here. Dosumu's checked in. Here's Terrell. Got a hand on it, and they get it back. Levine can't hit.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
The kick out to Tatum. Outside Holiday. Just 5 on the clock. Double team on Holiday. 3-pointer, Horford drains it from beyond the arc. Horford's got 6.
They need that floor spacing ability from Horford. It's big for them when he's knocking down triples.
Williams gets the bucket.
These are exactly the kind of shots they want to generate each and every time down the floor.
White, left side. The kick out to Holiday. Outside, Horford. Pass to White. Tipped away. Williams with the ball. Now guarded by Tatum. Here's Levine. Banked in off the glass. Levine's got 10 points here in the second half.
Just muscling through the contact. Levine is a flat-out star.
Outside Holiday. Now here's Horford. Here's Tatum. Oh, and the jam by Tatum.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying to get back into a game like this.
Ouch, Greg, that is definitely an emphasis jam. A big apostrophe or exclamation point, maybe even a question mark. Terrell, the pass to Levine, lets it go. Horford with the rebound.
Credit the defensive effort there, not giving him room to operate.
Pass to Cornette. Celtics passing it around. With some arc. No good that time. Excellent D there from Williams. Bulls trail by 13. GA, these Boston Celtics are unquestionably a top-tier offensive unit.
Stupendous shooting, excellent instincts with the ball. Yeah, they are a model offense in many ways, making it tough for many teams to keep up with them. Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
We know mistakes lead to breaks. That's just textbook right there.
Here's Terrell. And again, no good by Chicago.
He's having a tough quarter scoring the basketball, unable to help them close this gap.
Holiday with it. Williams picks him up. Here's White outside Holiday. And Derek White picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. So Chicago going with an... ends up going with the new group. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. To the inside. Whistle blows. And that's going to be a travel.
And all the turnovers, guys, are hurting his team. I mean, he's continuing to just give the ball away.
Celtics leading by 12. We've got Tatum. He's out there with Walker. And it's Springer in at the two spot. That's the Boston five.
That's going to draw a whistle every time down the floor. Not even close to being a legal screen.
That's a very avoidable turnover. You gotta focus on the details.
Here's Terrell. And the kick by Levine.
I'm going to tell you this. Defensively, you cannot let a streak shooter get a groove. And right now, Zach Levine, he is on fire.
It's been a nice stretch for them offensively.
I mean, the communication's great. The movement's been really good. This is solid team basketball.
Tillman passes to Pritchard. And good. And it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Pritchard's got 19 points.
Just outstanding distribution. This is the kind of team chemistry that you love to see.
And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Whatever adjustments were made in half, boy, they are working. He's looking like a different player since the break.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
Look, they're getting good looks inside. It's been a point of emphasis all night long, but I love this hard-nosed attitude of this team.
And we're also seeing a lot from them at the arc in this one. Tonight, it's been all about that three ball for these guys.
You know what? He's got to look to get other guys involved. The three-point stroke is off.
Here's Terrell. Springer, the pass to Pritchard. Inside, here's Tillman. Count it. And the Celtics lead by 11.
And a sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. And the jam by Levine.
We see this time and time again from Levine. He has the ability to put the offense on his shoulders.
Boston leading by 9. Knocks it loose. Springer, the pass to Pritchard. Tatum looking around. Tatum from 3.
They're in strong position coming down the stretch, and he is a big reason why.
Here's Terrell. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Terrell's got 26 points.
Love how selfless he is setting brick screens like this. Plays like that right there are what help create easy scoring opportunity.
Here's Pritchard. Rebound by the Bulls. Vucevic has got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. Williams a screen. Here's Terrell. And it's Williams with the jam.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
And that could be the spark they needed to make a little run as they try to even this thing up.
Pass to Tillman. Outside, Walker. They set the pick. Takes a 3. It's all in by the Bulls.
And let's be honest, they're winning in spite of his atrocious shooting performance.
Here's Terrell. Now, Vucevic. Shot clock at 6. 16 feet away. Goes back up. Rebounded by Tatum. Tatum's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Walker in the corner. And here we go, the Bulls, fast break. Giddy with it. He's picked up by Walker. Giddy, no good. Celtics leading by 8. Tatum passes to Springer. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Yeah, they got to do a much better job of putting a little bit of pressure on him on his way to the hoop.
Good on the bucket. That's 28 points for the franchise.
Okay, let's throw out the analytics for a moment. When he's taking the mid-range, it's a winning shot.
And here is Tatum. Pass to Pritchard. Good, and it's Tatum picking up the assist. Pritchard's got 22.
He was solid in the first half from deep. He's a guy who can get hot. Let's see how he does here in the second.
LaVine for 3. Springer pulls it in. Boston's gone 2-5 on 3-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And here's Tatum for 3. Good on the triple. Tatum's got 41.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. 3 of their last 5 baskets are from 3-point range.
LaVine for 3. Jason Tatum grabs the board. Tatum's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Bangs home the trifecta. And the Celtics lead by 17.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
LaVine gets a screen from Terrell. Celtics leading by 14. And so Joe Mazzulla calls for the timeout. He's very aware of the timing here and the significance of getting things squared away with his team. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
Thanks, guys. Listened in on what Joe Mazzulla told his team. He told them it's all about maintaining the lead. He told them he knows it's easy to get comfortable when you're in this position, but that they need to keep the pressure on. Guys?
Thanks, David. The 3 from Tatum. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Vucevic has got 15 rebounds here tonight. LaVine. Rebounded by Tatum. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. 17 points was their biggest margin.
So agile on the drive. When Tatum puts it on the deck, man, he is a major problem.
Now, here's Vucevic. Driving inside. Terrell, the pass to Williams. Here's Terrell, guarded by Holiday. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Working his way inside. Vooch ready to battle for it.
So he picks up just 1 from the line that time. And the NBA last season, Richard, really emphasizing it's an 82-game league. And I know you love that.
Oh, that is my favorite thing. I was taught by the legends of the game that you go out there and play every single night that you can. At some point in time, the sports and science team realized that it is very difficult to be a professional. But I stand by. 82 games is an achievement that very few can achieve now.
Yeah, and it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Williams passes to Terrell. Giddy gets a screen from Terrell. Out to the right wing. Clock at 6. Takes the 13-footer. And Boston with the rebound. Holiday's got 4 rebounds in this game.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
pass to Terrell. Vucevic, a screen on Howard. Outside Williams. Some nice ball movement here by the Bull. Here's Terrell. Shot clock at 5. Right side Levine. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It goes on Jason Tatum.
The springing athlete, everybody knows about Levine and his bounce. He's just hard to check. And look, he was fouled right there.
And Richard, you look back. Zach LaVine has been one of those microwave-type players. He can get hot in a blink of an eye.
Zach LaVine is one of those players that when he catches fire, there is nothing you can do about it. He can score from deep, multiple-level score. And when he gets going, ooh, it could be a problem.
Celtics leading by 17. Outside, White puts it up.
He hasn't had his best game, but they've gotten enough production elsewhere, so it hasn't really mattered.
Vucevic down low, guarded by Horford from outside the arc. The rebound by the Celtics.
There has been nothing for him this quarter. Ever since halftime, he's lost all of his touch.
In the corner, Tatum with it. And the dunk by Tatum.
We see this from Tatum often, and it never gets old. Just scoring at will.
Giddy with the screen on Holiday. Here's Terrell. Excellent D there from Holiday. Boston's gotten 8 shots off from three-point land and hit half of them. Rebounded by Vucevic. Vucevic has got his 16th rebound on the night. There's 1:54 left here in the fourth quarter. They get it back. To the left side wing. Here's Terrell. And the Bulls with another miss.
This is the definition of forcing it. He's trying to get himself going, but taking tough shots just won't do it.
The 3 from Tatum. Chicago grabs the miss. LaVine's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Celtics.
You know, their big advantage was points in the paint.
And they found a way to pound the ball inside. And that was working all game long.
So looking at the season total, this will be their 17th win.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won 2 straight.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Jason Tatum.
He did a great job following his team's game plan and not rushing anything on offense, which allowed him to catch fire.
Holiday with it. Five on the clock. Takes the 13-footer. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. And the Celtics lead by 19. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Williams, a screen on Holiday. Terrell drops it in from 14 feet away. Terrell's got 30. Here's the Celtics with the ball, and they can just let the clock run out here.
Cannot argue with the W.
Outside, White. Pressure. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. Alongside Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony and our reporter David Aldridge and the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.